Welcome to today's episode, my friends, of the Big Ball Brawl. We got a new top team, top 5% as the number one free-to-play player. Excited to break it down for you in today's episode. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy, make sure to like and subscribe. It's a great way to stay connected. And if you got a question, if you got a comment throughout, let me know because I love to hear from you as always. Now, in today's episode, we'll quickly go over what the Big Ball Brawl is. If this is your first time, you can check out our other main video. Additionally, we'll break down that team, a couple things that led to this team, and then we'll go for that run, my friends, as always. So let's get into it today because we got a lot to cover. So first and foremost, Big Ball Brawl, you can check out most of the other details, but this is a key event going on right now. We got 12 days left here. And as a free-to-play player, this stuff is very important to me because we love to get rewards. That's right. And that makes a huge, huge difference. At one point, I was top 5%. We've kind of slipped now to between 5 and 10%, which is why I want to make this video for you here today. What you're doing is you're running in, dealing damage to this boss, and then getting a score. There's a couple different strategies that we have covered, and today is the new strategy that we did actually mention, and this is going to be the team, the tactics, and the treasures and toppings in order to help you succeed. It is going to be this one right here. So we mentioned poison as a key variable here. In some of the previous events, poison has always done very, very well. And in fact, when this one stood up, we had a poison team already built. However, since then, we've had a couple of tweaks. Now, about this particular team, a couple things that I did do and find that I do want to share. Now, Dark Choco here needs to be on a plus one magic candy at least. Now, I actually ran this at a baseline with Black Raisin, and Black Raisin did better than this. However, at the top end, surprisingly, Dark Choco did a little bit better. We'll talk about some of those tweaks and things that you can make, and I'm going to have another video on helping you make the considerations for your best team as well. So stay tuned for that and subscribe to stay tuned as a great way and turn on those notifications. All right, so here we go with this particular team. It revolves around poison. Really, these three here doing most of it. We got Matcha Cookie in here as well. That really enhances a lot of those pieces, similar to Royal Margarine here. And then additionally with Dark Choco, it's really about lowering the defense. So other alternative swaps could be things like Rubble. We talked a little bit about Black Raisin. You could try Milky Way, those kinds of things. And we'll talk about some of that in that next video as well. Now, in terms of Linzer here, Linzer's that huge damage amplifier with the lovely suspect. Now, in terms of our treasure setup here, what you're trying to do is you're focused on damage. You're kind of going a little bit slower here as well because of the fact that you want to get Linzer to get all those stacks in and make that happen. So it really, really changes the speed on these particular cookies, which can be very, very important for this particular team. Play around in terms of what's going to make sense for you and how that's going to work for your particular grouping. Certainly, again, you could consider robes, you could consider the lovely Sleepy Eyes Jelly Watch to kind of go a little bit lower on that cooldown. You do have the cooldown there. However, this was the right setup for me. And again, everything's plus 12, so that can be balanced out along with these particular cookies. The main difference on the cookies though, again, because it's not giving you 5-star for everything, there is where you can make tweaks and better balancing. And additionally, the last place here is our gear. Now, I certainly have room for improvement, which also gives you as a free-to-play player, returning player, new veteran, all those things, a lot of areas of opportunity as well. When it comes to our toppings, generally, we're going to recommend a Resident Radiant for the particular cookies, and we're going to recommend the biscuits that match, like Resolute or the Tainted, those kinds of things. However, right now for Dark Choco, we don't have that. Generally, you're going to want 3 to 4 if you can max all this stuff out. Amazing, great, lots of room for opportunity. There's a little trick here that you can check out for our other videos on why I'm not level 30. It'd be nice to be level 30. However, as a free-to-play player, I'm trying to save my material so that I can get to 4 and max those to 30 as an example. So just a little bit about that. However, you could do, my score could go way up if I tweak all this stuff to perfection, right? So a couple things here. We're on cooldown because we want to keep those stacks on. We're at that for our biscuit here on matcha. We're at 30. I did swap with my Frost Queen. So those are one of the things that you can use as a strategy is flipping between the two. I took notes. Don't forget because you want to put it back on those particular cookies. Here we could go to level 5 star promotion. This is available to you in the mileage shop. I haven't done it, something that you could do. We're on attack here. Here we're on attack. Same thing with Royal Margarine. We could go to 5. Also, we could tweak this a little bit more as well here. We certainly have this one on and available for us because Prue and I've made an investment in to go to 30 because it's a very useful cookie for a lot of things like this event. And then here we're on Caramel for the attack speed. And Linzer, again, could use a couple improvements. However, very good survivability. In this particular event, we don't need healers. We don't need survivability, honestly. So we could change a lot of stuff on these things. And that is just tweaking to Heart's Desire to get to where you want to be. Now, once again, this is the key team that I found to get me here, where I currently stand, a top 5% plus for sure in the Big Ball Brawl that you can use and leverage. And we talked about some of the key pieces and tweaks. The last thing here that's really, really important is these random effects. Where this team really excels is when you can get that additional periodic damage boost, and we have a boost to bosses, you can get the attack boost, all that. We do have a cooldown here for minus 10%. I did make an investment a ton just to get to this so I could show it for today's video. Again, it is capped at 2,500. If you need ideas on how to get more of your coins and currency, all that, we do have a guide for you here on the channel that you can check out. All right, my friends. So that is a little bit of the Big Ball Brawl very quickly. The new team here, some of the ideas and swaps and those things that kind of help you. And again, the one that got us here in our new record as well. So let's go ahead and take it out for a spin so that you can see exactly how this one is going to run and work. Now, there are some things that we've heard or talked about, at least in the Discord server. If you go down to one speed, you can sit there and click everything as well. Sometimes that will make your score a little bit better because some of these casts and those things might get in a little bit faster than those pieces as well, which can make a difference in your score. So a little bit of a tweaking like that even can go a very, very long way, my friends. So let's see how this is going to go for us here today. Look at that. Moving. Can we get to 2 million? That would be nice. Not quite. Dun, dun, dun. So again, very important there though. My other one did about 1.8 million or billion. We can certainly tweak that way as well. However, again, this was our high score with this particular team with this setup. So I like to share that. Probably getting away from that cookies cooldown makes a difference and the attack. Let's go ahead. We'll do one more run so that you can see it once again and see if we can hit something very, very good. Lifetime summon units, damage to boss, team gains, and common cookies. Here we go. Let's run with that one because we got three on it. So those small tweaks, all like I said, can make a difference. If we lift the level up, if we add some of those other pieces and tweaks in the beast kits, now this team will certainly do more damage. The goal is here is definitely you want to get that Linzer, all the suspect stacks there at 7. There you go. And here we are. Getting these poison stacks on is also key. So again, getting a little bit more cooldown on prune juice could make that difference to really, really get those stacks in. So you can keep that in mind as well. Here we go. It's really starting to load in here. Oh, it's going to be close. We're going to be right below again. Anyway, I promise that is the key piece. Now let's go back to these cookies. I can show one other thing here quickly for you. When we do go to our gear, you can also tweak these with some in between where you kind of mix them if you'd like to. I don't generally do that. We could go on cooldown here so you can see that instead with prune. There we go, because that should increase some of those stacks. We'll go one more time. Oops. One more time. Damage to bosses. Oops, I should have used that one. There we go. All periodic ambush. Let's go for it. So this will show hopefully a little bit more of those poison stacks. So instead of that 30, we'll get maybe up to 50 as well. So you can see that. So pay attention to how those are coming on for our particular prune juice as well. So there they are. They're stuck at the 25, going up 29, 32, 33, 34. There we go, more stacks. So we're above, as you can see. That was a key piece. Again, getting more of those stacks is going to create more damage as well. So there's that blend between the attack and the cooldown that can make a huge difference for you. So there we go, we're almost up to 40. So wanted to show that one last piece there for you today. Now, I do promise this is the team that I did. I'm probably not going to be able to get it live right now, and I think it's a good amount for today's episode. So with that, that is our new poison team, the team that did get us to the 3 billion plus damage, which is awesome. We talked about a little bit of some of the tweaks, some of the things that you can do, some of the random effects to make it happen. And then generally, like I say, just keep on trying. The good thing is this event isn't super expensive at all, so you can just keep working and keep tweaking your particular team for success. And with that, my friends, I hope you enjoyed today's Big Ball Brawl episode as the number one free-to-play player. If you still got a question, if you got a comment, let me know, because I'd love to hear from you as always, and would love to see you in our amazing community and Discord server, my friends. And with that, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for tuning in today. I appreciate your support. Thank you for the likes and the subs as we continue to grow this amazing community here as always. And on top of that, thank you to all of our members. We do have memberships available too. We got emotes, icons for that, video, other fun videos, those kinds of things. Additionally, affiliate links and a swag and merch store that you can check out. And with that, once again, thank you. And we have our socials at me, chat me, stay connected, my friends. We'll see you out there. Big Ball Brawl. Get up there. You can do this. I promise. It's a lot of fun. And with that, keep on running, my friends.